In this video, we are going to discuss the balancing of several masses rotating in different planes. Let us consider the problem statement. Four masses, capital A, B, C and capital D, as shown below, are to be completely balanced. The mass is given in terms of kilogram. The mass of A is to be found out. The mass of B, it is 30 kg. Mass of C, it is 50 kg. And mass D is 40 kg. The radius, it is given in terms of millimeter. For A, it is 180 millimeter. For B, it is 240 millimeter. For C, it is 120. And for D, it is 150 millimeter. The planes containing mass B and C are 300 millimeter apart. The angle between the planes containing B and C, it is 90 degree. Between B and C makes an angle of 210 degree and 120 degree respectively with capital D. In the same sense, that is in the same direction, if you measure, find first the magnitude and the angular position of mass A and D, and second one, that is the angular, that is the position of A and D in terms of the linear form. So here, as per the given statement, the radius for the mass A, it is 180 millimeter, is 0.18 meter. The mass at B, it is 30 kg. For B, the radius, it is given as 240 millimeter, so 0.24 meter. Mass at C, it is 50 kg. It is at radius 120 millimeter, so that means 0.12 meter. And mass D, it is at 40 kg, and it is at radius 150 millimeter, that is 0.15 meter. The angle BOC is given as 90 degree. The angle BOD is given as 210 degree, and the angle COD, it is given as 120 degree. So let us consider MA, it is the magnitude of mass, capital A, in terms of kilogram. So first thing, we have to draw the position of planes. So here we have shown the position of plane in terms of a simple sketch. So here it is the plane for B and the plane for C. It is 300 millimeters apart. The distance of plane A, it is not mentioned in this particular case. And the distance of this particular plane D from B, it is also not mentioned in this particular case. So here I have considered this x, it is the distance between the plane B and D. So here it is, at x distance we have drawn the plane capital D, and whereas I have considered y, it is the distance between the plane A and B. So therefore, at y distance we have placed the plane for capital A. Now the next step, we have to tabulate this particular data in terms of the columns and rows. So here, the first column, it is in terms of the plane. The second column, it is in terms of the mass in kg. Next one, it is for the radius in meters. The next column, it is for the centrifugal force divided by omega square. So omega, it is the constant entity for all the masses. So we can see that it is directly proportional to product of mass into the radius in terms of kg meter. The next column, it is the distance from the reference plane in terms of the meter. And the last column, it is the couple divided by omega square. So that is the product of this centrifugal force M into R into the length, that is M into R into L in terms of kg meter square. So we have to find out all this particular entity for the plane A, for the plane B, for the plane C and for the plane D. So here we are considering this P plane. So here it is, this B plane we have considered as the reference plane. Okay, that means if I measure the distance on right hand side, so it will be positive entity from this reference plane, and if I measure the distance on left hand side, so it will be the negative side, so as it is a reference plane. Now let us consider for the mass A, so in the plane capital A, so the mass T is not given, so therefore in the plane A the mass it is MA, the radius it is 0.18 meter, okay, so therefore the product of these two it will be 0.18 into MA. The distance from the reference plane, so here it is the reference plane, so from B it is along the negative side, so therefore it is in terms of minus y, and here the couple you will get is the product of these two, so therefore the product of these two you will get minus 0.18 MA y. okay, so now this B plane, it is the reference plane we have considered, so at this plane the mass it is 30, the radius it is 0.24, the product of these two m into r it is 7.2, the distance from reference plane, so obviously it will be 0, therefore this product it will come 0. For the plane C, the mass it is 50 kg, the radius it is 0.12, so the product of these two m into r it will be 6, the distance from the reference plane it is 300 millimeter, so that means 0.3 meter, so the product of these two, so it will be 1.8. and lastly at the plane capital D, the mass it is 40 kg, the radius it is 0.15, therefore the centrifugal force that is m into r will get it is 6, and the distance from the reference plane it is at distance x, and the product of this will get it as 6x. Now after this, by considering this, we have to draw the vector diagram. So here we can see the centrifugal force, so here I will get it is in terms of the force polygon, we can construct the force polygon, and here we can construct the couple polygon. So here if I consider this particular row or this column, so only one entity it is unknown, so first thing we have to start with the force polygon and then we have to move towards the couple polygon. So here we have to draw the angular position of masses first. So here we have drawn the angular position of masses B, C and D. So here it is B and C, it is 90 degree to each other. The angle between this C and D, so it is 120 degree. So now for the next step we have to consider the force polygon, that is the vector diagram. So therefore we have considered a scale 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kg meter. So here we have to start with the force polygon, The magnitudes are, it is in terms of kg meter. So these are the magnitude. So first we will start with the mass at B. The magnitude it is 7.2. Okay. And the direction of the position, we'll get it for this vector, it is in the horizontal position. It is in the horizontal position. So anywhere we can mark the O point as a origin. The origin point as O, and here first we'll draw the vector for the magnitude of 7.2. So here it is, the magnitude of 7.2. This is the first vector. So this vector, we have drawn it for the plane B. Then the next magnitude, it is for the mass in the plane C. It is 6 kg meter, 6 kg meter, and the position from B, it is at 90 degree. So it is at 90 degree. So at 90 degree, to this we can draw the next vector it indicates the magnitude as 6 kg meter in the plane C. Okay. Now, in the D plane, again the magnitude it is 6, and the position from C, it is at 120 degree. It is at 120 degree. So here, this is the vector for the mass in plane capital D. So this is the point small d for the magnitude as 6 kg meter. Now if I join this starting point and the end point, so this will be the balanced force. In the plane capital A. So this will be the balanced force. So if I consider this, so this is equal to the entity as 0.18 MA. So balanced force, or the entity 0.18 MA. Force polygon. This vector OD bar is equal to this magnitude as 0.18 MA. Okay. So therefore, by measurement we can find out this OD bar is equal to 3.6 kg meter. Okay. So therefore, by this will get the mass at A is equal to 20 kg. So this is the magnitude of mass at plane A. It is 20 kg. Now for the angular position, for the mass at A, I have to transfer this particular vector in this particular angular position of masses. So by means of a drafter or by means of roller scale, we can transfer it and we can measure the angle. We can measure the angle in the anti-clockwise direction from B. So either I can measure in the clockwise direction, but here all the angles are given in this anti-clockwise sense. So therefore we have to measure this A also in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So here we can measure this particular angle directly. Here it is also, or either I can transfer it here also. So here we have transferred this particular position of vector. If I measure this particular angle here, so we'll get it as 56 degrees with this. And if I transfer it here, and if I measure from this mass B in anti-clockwise direction, so that will be the angle theta A. So this is the case. We'll get this particular angle. It is in terms of 180 plus this 56 degrees. So this will be 236 degrees. So this is the magnitude of mass at A. It is 20 kg, and this is the angular position, 236 degrees, in anti-clockwise direction from mass B. Now, in order to find out the position of plane, that is plane A and D, so that will be found out if I get the distance y and x from this particular plane B. So here, if I consider this couple polygon, so here it is -0.18 mAy, and here it is the entity 6x. So if I draw this couple polygon, so by this particular end I'll get this both the entity, that is the position of plane A and plane D. So let us start with the couple polygon. The magnitude for this particular couple polygon, if I start, so we have to start with this particular known entity. This is at plane capital C. The magnitude, it is 1.8. The magnitude, it is the 1.8. Okay. So here, for this, we have to consider the scale. So we'll consider the same scale. That is 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kg meter square. 1 kg meter square. Now with this we have to construct the couple polygon. So let us start with the mass at C, and the magnitude, it is 1.8. the magnitude is 1.8. so therefore the position of mass at C, so just you can see it is 90 degree to this particular horizontal position B. So that means it is in the vertical position. So therefore anywhere we'll consider the point as O dash. This is the starting point, and from this I'll draw a vector for the mass at C. So this is the magnitude 1.8, and this is the point C dash.
this is the point C dash. For the mass at D, we don't know the angular, we don't know the magnitude, but we know that the angular position. The angular position, it is with respect to the C, it is at 120 degree. This one. So we can align your roller scale to this, and we can construct a line through this C dash, which is at 120 degree. For the magnitude as 6x, we don't know the exact magnitude, but this will be the angular position. Degree, we can mark the magnitude as 6x. We don't know the exact length of vector, so that we have drawn the reference line. Now the next part, that is for the plane at A. So here either we can calculate this particular magnitude, but we don't know the exact magnitude of y for that, so that is also we don't know. So therefore we can draw it by taking the reference of this angular position of the vector, this one. So this is the angular position, so we can take the reference of this. And from this O dash, we can draw the reference line for the magnitude at A. The second reference line, which is parallel to this vector 0.18 ma, and this is with the magnitude as 0.18 ma y. So the minus sign. So here we have got the point of intersection, and that point it is D dash. Okay. So here this is the magnitude as 6x C dash to D dash, while this is the magnitude O dash to D dash. For the couple in plane A. Okay. Therefore, from couple polygon, the vector C dash D dash. It indicates the magnitude as 6x. So therefore, by measurement, so C dash D dash, so this is the vector, so this distance into the scale is equal to this entity as 6x. So here it is, the scale it is in terms of 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kg meter square. So what will be the length we will measure? So that will be, it is in terms of kg per meter square. So therefore, if I measure this, so I will get this entity as 2.3 into 1 is equal to 6x. So if you simplify, you will get this distance as 0.383 meter. Okay. Or either it is 383 millimeter. In terms of millimeter. Now, if I consider this vector, so vector O dash D dash is equal to the magnitude as minus 0.18 MAy. Okay, so therefore O dash D dash into scale is equal to minus 0.18 MAy. So now if I measure this, so this entity I'll get 3.6 into 1 is equal to minus 0.18 MAy. So here if I consider this MA, we have calculated it as 20. So by this I'll get this value for y as minus 1 meter. Okay, so here this is the position of x, that is 383 millimeter, and the position of y, it is -1 millimeter. So if I concentrate on this minus sign we have got, so it indicates the plane A, it is not towards the left of the B. So if I consider, okay, so here we have considered this particular plane A, it is on the left side of B. Okay, so it is not toward the left, whatever we have assumed, but it should be towards the right side of the plane B. So this is the indication of the minus sign. So here negative sign indicates plane A is not towards left of B as assumed. It is towards right. So this is the meaning of this negative sign. Okay, so this is the case. The position of this particular plane, I'll get it again in the revised form. So in this way we can find it. As per the given statement, the plane B and C, these are at 300 millimeters distance apart. And from the solution we have found out that the plane A, it is towards right from B at 1000 millimeters apart, or 1 meters apart. That's all.